yerba mate teas have been consumed for centuries by the South American indigenous peoples, and today certain regions of Latin America have a quart a day. So understanding what's in mate is important, particularly if there are high levels of carcinogenic polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, including one of the most potent, benzopyrene, which is known to be cancer-causing in humans, and is found concentrated in cigarette smoke, grilled and barbecued meat, and mate. These carcinogenic compounds are fat-soluble, though, and may not readily transfer from the mate leaves into the water. Turns out transfer rates can be anywhere between 1% to 50%, depending on the brewing method, but levels in mate leaves are so high that even if about 5% transfers into the tea, heavy mate consumption could be the benzopyrene equivalent to smoking about 4 cigarettes. Each cigarette has about 10 nanograms, so that would be like 40 nanograms, or the amount of carcinogenic benzopyrene found in about 1/10 of a serving of grilled chicken. OK, but a direct comparison between breathing in the chemical versus eating or drinking it may be inaccurate because we absorb it differently. Maybe, but when the levels of a breakdown product of these kinds of chemicals was measured in the urine of smokers versus mate drinkers, those who drank more than 2 or 4 cups of mate a day appeared to have as much of these carcinogens flowing through their systems as smokers. OK, but does this actually translate out into higher cancer rates? I mean, mate has more antioxidant power than green tea, significantly increasing the antioxidant capacity of the bloodstream to those randomized to drink it. So might the good outweigh the bad? Apparently not. Mate drinkers have about double the odds of cancers of the mouth, throat, esophagus, and voice box.